You're at 600 West Maple Road, Troy, Michigan.
Thank you. if they would say, oh, we're nailing it. Like, we know exactly what's going on with our kids. Because I think there's a language that young people have that we don't necessarily always understand. And I think we would be remiss were we not to talk about social media, right? And the ways in which social media supports for good, but also the ways in which social media might be negatively impacting our young people. So I think there are these kind of missing in translation, right? Or lost in translation thing that happens between parents, caregivers, and kids, and young people, and young adults, that prevent us from really being able to dive in and understand fully what our young people are going through. So I would say we have compassion for many of us as parents and caregivers. I would say that what we're missing is understanding the exact language that our young people use to try to communicate with us, to teach us what they need and what they're going through in terms of their own mental health. I always try to encourage parents and caregivers to do one thing. I encourage them to think about trusting their gut. If they're asking you the question as you just said, then that probably means you want to dive in a little deeper. Because I think if it were not a question that you needed to be worried about, you wouldn't be wondering, you wouldn't be asking. And so I think what I always want parents and caregivers to do is, in addition to trusting their gut, trust their intuition, pay attention to your young person's behavior. Like I tell my kids all the time, sometimes I feel like I know you better than you know yourself, right? Because I'm watching the patterns from outside. If you see your child's patterns changing, are they sleeping a lot more? Are they a lot less? Eating a lot more? Eating a lot less? You know, like these kinds of things. And you see this lasting over time. That's your clue that you at least want to start having a conversation with your young person about noticing these things and then able. And then ask the young person, what do you think about that? What do you think about what I've just shared with you? And hopefully that leads to a conversation that can illuminate some things for that parent or caregiver.
Changed my life because stress used to rule my life.